So let's talk about DC movies. And let's talk about the recent one that came out that a lot of people are saying that it's a big fail in the box office. And that is Harley Quinn and the Birds of Prey. Now, if you're a comic book fan, I understand why you're disappointed with this movie. But if you're not a comic book fan, let me explain to you why this movie failed. See, with the Birds of Prey in the comic books, Harley Quinn is nowhere around. I almost said wound, but around. And this recent movie that came out recently, Harley Quinn and the Birds of Prey, it was more about Harley Quinn than it is more about the Birds of Prey. So we could pretty much sit there and say Harley Quinn and her bitches, which is sad to say because some of the women in the Birds of Prey are actually really good heroes in the comic books if you go read up on them. Like for instance, Black Canary. She, at the end of the movie, she uses her power and she only uses it one time, which was a bummer. But it is what it is, really. But not just her, we also had Huntress in the movie as well, which is also a really cool character to have in DC Comics. So like I said, the Birds of Prey characters were kind of loosely not really who they really supposed to be. If you compare them to the movie characters, compare them to the comic book characters, they are like nowhere close to who they're really supposed to be. I could say Black Canary maybe, but Harley Quinn is probably the closest thing that's spot on to her actual character because this is a movie all about her and her alone, which I feel wasn't the best idea, to be honest with you, because one, I see Harley Quinn as just, DC's version of Deadpool. It's really, the similarities are there. She breaks the fourth wall. She's real comedic, she's really raunchy and gross sometimes. But it's just sad how that, okay, DC wants to do their version of Deadpool, and this time they made it into a woman. Now, is she overrated? Yes, very overrated. Because I imagined to see Joker in the movie. I really wanted to see Joker in the movie, how the breakup went, what caused the breakup. We usually know how the breakup is usually caused by Batman, because Joker was trying to probably do some heist and Harley Quinn fucked up again and they split up. So that's pretty much how usually Joker and Harley Quinn usually break up. But in this movie, she's trying to show the world that, oh, I'm better off without Mr. J, and I'ma do me, I'ma be my own villain. And it's kind of funny that this movie comes out around the time the Harley Quinn cartoon animated series on DC Universe comes out as well. So it's kind of like Harley Quinn overload. But I honestly thought that in this movie we were going to get like a more thorough, history or background to each character besides Harley Quinn, because like I said, we already know who Harley Quinn is in this movie. But really, we wanted to talk about the other characters, because like I said, Black Canary has a really good background. Huntress, from what they have said in the movie, she has a really good background. Cassandra Cain is probably the worst character in this movie, even though in the comics she's kick ass. Black Canary doesn't look like her character. Renee Montoya don't. Cassandra Cain doesn't. Huntress, somewhat. And of course, Harley Quinn's character kind of looks like her character. So it's kind of like you kind of didn't really do these characters justice. Cassandra Cain is probably the biggest thing here. If you're a comic book fan, Cassandra Cain is known as the Orphan, and she doesn't talk. Now, I forgot if either her voice box was ripped out or her voice box was cut or something, but pretty much she is an orphan and Batman takes her in just like he does every other, little kid that he came across. He does make her the next Batgirl instead of the next Robin. Birds of Prey was labeled pretty bad. It wasn't good in the box office, and I wouldn't say that we should get a sequel. DC honestly needs to do better with their movies, but instead they rather keep, dishing out these, I guess, B-plus movies. Understand they're trying to be up there with Marvel, and I like the effort that they're doing. Justice League was pretty good in my book, but instead they don't want to, release the Zack Snyder cut. And the Zack Snyder Justice League movie, from what I've read, sounds pretty freaking amazing. And I feel like they should go that route. But for some reason, they don't want to. I mean, Shazam was good. Wonder Woman was good. Aquaman was good. Hopefully, the Flash movie is good. But for now, we don't even know if that's going to happen or not. Because the guy that plays the Flash is hot water at the moment. But we'll have to see. But honestly, my opinion, Birds of Prey wasn't that good. Certain aspects of it was. Black Mask was hilarious. Harley Quinn was funny. You know, normally she's funny. But the rest of it was just all like, I can do without her narrating the movie. I can do without all that. We can do without that. But guys, what do you guys think? Did y'all like the movie? Did y'all even enjoy it? Do y'all think that it was a waste of time and money? Do you think that DC should have used this time and money on something different? Just let me know in the comments below. But other than that, guys, that's all I got for y'all. Peace.